Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my beloved children. MashaAllah, tabarakallah. Today I want to talk about some verses of the Quran that we all read so often. MashaAllah. It is known as Surah Al-Fatiha. The opening verses of the Quran, we always read it in Salah, we always read it in every unit of prayer or every rak'ah. So why is it so important? It's important because Allah mentions in it so much of goodness. It's known as Al-Fatiha, which means the opening surah. It's known as Ummul Kitab, the mother of the book, which is the Quran, which means it's very, very important. It's also known as As-Sab'ul Mathani, which means the seven verses that are repeated so often. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praise is due to Allah, Lord of the worlds. So we praise Allah for everything He gave us. Allah gave us everything we have. Look, if you were to think what Allah gave you, He gave you your hands and your nose and your face and your feet and your tongue and your voice and your taste buds and your eyes and everything. Together with that, He's given you a family, a home, food, whatever else it may be. Some people have less and some people might have lost a few things, but Allah still has blessed us in so many ways. We must always say, Alhamdulillah, all praise is due to Allah. Rabbil Alameen, Lord of the world. So this is the first verse, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Then we say, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim are two qualities of the mercy of Allah. He forgives us when we do things that are wrong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives us. He is merciful. He is kind. So Ar-Rahman is a mercy that encompasses all creatures. And Ar-Rahim is a special mercy for those who believe. So these are the qualities of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. Then He is the owner of the Day of Judgment, Maliki Yawmiddin. Maliki Yawmiddin means when I die and I get back to Allah, Allah is going to judge between all of us in those matters which we disagreed in, which we didn't perhaps fulfill. Whatever I've done on earth, Allah is going to judge. So Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawmiddin. Allah is the owner of the Day of Judgment, and I'm going to give all my records to Allah. So when I've done something wrong, I need to seek the forgiveness of Allah, because when I say, oh Allah, forgive me, Allah forgives me. I must not doubt that. When I say, oh Allah, forgive me for what I did, I regret it, I don't like it, I'm not going to do it again. Allah says, no problem, I've forgiven you. It's wiped out. But He is the owner of the Day of Judgment. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. You alone we worship, you alone we ask for help. So when I want help, I ask Allah alone. When I worship Allah alone. Now, what if Allah has given the capacity to someone to give me something I know and I can see physically this person has the capacity to give me this? Can I ask that person for that? For example, I'm sitting on the table. I need, for example, the ketchup from the other side of the table or the pies on that other side of the table. And I say, please, can you pass me the pies? Does it mean I'm asking someone besides Allah for something? The answer is no. You know, you can see with your eyes, Allah's given them the capacity to pass it to you. But if Allah wants, He can stop it. Maybe that thing can break. Maybe this person won't be able to reach it. So still, when we ask from Allah. And we know that Allah alone will give us. So this is something amazing. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. You alone we worship. Because when we worship, we only worship He who made us. We will not worship anyone else. So whoever made me, that's who I worship. MashaAllah. I worship Him alone. Because I'm going to return to Him. Whoever made me, before I was born, I was somewhere. When I die, I'm going to go back to wherever I was, back to the same Allah who created me in the first place. So this is Maliki Yawmiddin, Iyaka Na'budu wa Iyaka Nasta'in. Then I ask Allah's guidance, because guidance is the most important thing I could ever have. Subhanallah. Ihdina as-sirat al-mustaqim. Guide us to the straight path. Show us the way. Show us what to do, what not to do. Help us to walk on that path. This is amazing, because it's the most important dua, the most important supplication, call to Allah. I want to ask Allah something. What should I ask Him for first? Before money and before my toys and before my things and before passing the worldly tests and school and whatever, I need to say, oh Allah, guide me to the straight path, the path of those whom You have favored, whom You love, whom You have gifted, not the path of those who have earned your anger, nor the path of those who have gone astray. In the previous nations, there were those who knew the truth. Allah sent them what to do, what not to do. They didn't walk on that path. So Allah says, those who knew the truth and went away from the truth, Allah was displeased with them. They earned the anger of Allah. And those who were astray, subhanAllah, they were not even interested in the truth. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness. So then at the end, when we say, غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَضَّالِينَ, we say Ameen. So remember, in between we say Sirata alladhina an'amta alayhim, the path of those whom you have gifted or favored. May we be from among them. My brothers, my beloved children, my sisters, I tell you, this is the reason why we repeat this verse so much. And this is the reason why we repeat the surah so much, because Allah loves it. He wants us to be focused on this particular surah. So learn it and repeat it. And when you read it, you must know its meaning. And whenever we start off, we say, Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, in the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. I explained to you the difference between Ar-Rahman and Ar-Rahim. I hope you remember. And inshallah, I look forward to seeing you guys again. This was a short explanation. Because we're in the month of Ramadan, we're doing Taraweeh. Every rak'ah, every unit, we are reading Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawmiddin. We need to know what that is all about. So I thought I'd explain to you, my beloved children, what's being said. Allah bless you all. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.